obviously, we were all shocked when we heard the news. Nobody is really insured from crisis in this world.
I was scared. I would have been scared. Definitely.
It was a perfect day to come to the National Harbor, with temperatures in the 60s and the sun shining. But the threat that hit the harbor recently didn't stop people from going about their normal routine.
You can't just stay in the house and just, you know, be fearful. You have to live.
Police say Rondell Henry, a Maryland resident, had plans to attack National Harbor with a stolen U-Haul truck when he was arrested in March.
It's indescribable what would happen, how would everybody feel. It would be a travesty.
Important to remember, first of all, that terrorism is really rare.
And William Braniff, director of the National Consortium for the Study of Terrorism and Responses to Terrorism, said that acts of terrorism are rare and people should not live every day in fear.
60% of terrorist attacks that do occur don't injure or kill anyone. So we should be much more concerned about driving on the Beltway than an act of terrorism affecting us personally.
And residents here in National Harbor are determined to continue life as normal.
I'm definitely not going to change my routine. There's always going to be a threat of people like that. And if we're going to start changing our way of living to accommodate, you know, this individual, so we're all going to lose.
In National Harbor, Makia Luzader, CNS TV.